Hello everyone, this is Shivani here. Welcome to my channel Shivani Creations. Today I am showing you how to make this gorgeous photo frame with these handmade flower decoration. And this is a shadow box photo frame. Can you see this small shadow box in which I have added photograph? And this is in vintage style. And from top you can just take out your photograph and you can stand it on your desk as well. So let's get started. For this we need handmade paper roses, liquid glue, pearl drops, scissor, mount board or cardboard, chocolatey color cardstock, pattern paper and acetate sheet or OHP sheet. First I am taking this piece of mount board which measures 19 by 25 centimeters and I am wrapping it using this vintage pattern paper. This is by Dress My Craft. So this is done and our base is ready. Now on back I am making a stand. For this I am taking this mount board piece which measures 5 by 19 cm and I am taking this pattern paper strip which is little longer than this mount board piece. In bottom I have just folded on 2 5.5 and 9 cm and folded like a zigzag. So it should look like a M shape. Now I am just adding my mount board piece with this. And it's done. Now just covering the back portion of our base mount board using brown craft paper. Then take your stand and just add glue on the top folded part and the bottom folded part and connect exactly in the center of your frame. And it's ready. Now I'm taking one more mount board piece which measures 17 by 13 centimeters and I am going to wrap it using brown color cardstock. Mm-hmm. like this. Now here in the corner I have added gold foils. So I have just added small strips of double-sided tacky tape in the corners. And now I am going to show you how to do the process using reactive golden foils. So I have just cut this strip from the reactive foil pack. This is by Dress My Craft again, and I am using golden color. They have huge variety of these foils. Now just remove your liner, put your foil on top of this, rub it properly, and then just take it out slowly. And can you see how beautiful and easy to decorate any portion? You can add your tape in any manner to decorate your cards, your scrapbooks. In the same way, I'm repeating it on the other side. And it's done. Now I'm showing you how to create frame. So for this we need these two strips, which measures 4 by 13 centimeters, and this measures 4 by 10 centimeters. So I'm starting with the smaller one first. So just take your 4 by 10 centimeter strip, and from left side I'm marking on 1, 1.5, 2.5 and 3 centimeters, similarly marking in the bottom. Now join these markings and make a crease line. Then fold all the creases. I am just cutting little strip from one side so that it will be easy to fold and stick. Now just add little glue on this small strip and connect like this. So it should look like a rectangle pipe. And it's done. In the same way, I have prepared one more rectangle pipe like this. Now I'm taking the bigger strip, and from left side again I'm marking on 1, 1.5, 2.5 and 3 centimeters, similarly mark in the bottom and make a crease line and fold all the creased parts. Then on this side I am marking on 1 centimeter from left and right sides. Now can you see the second crease line? So you have to create a straight line till this second line, second crease line, and then join it diagonally with the next crease line. Similarly I am repeating on this side. Can you see it clearly? It's very easy. Now I'm going to cut this pencil marking using my scissor. And then I'm again cutting a small slit on this part and then sticking using glue. So this is also done. In the same way I have created one more pipe. So we have two large and two small pipes. Now I am going to join these pipes with each other to construct the frame. So just add glue on this big pipe and adhere the small pipe like this. So in this method you can create any size of frame. Thank you. and the frame is ready. Very easy. Now, on back side of the frame, I am adding 3 mount board pieces strips so that we can slide photograph from top. So I am adding these strip only on 3 sides. Like this. Now on front side I have added double sided tacky tape, so just removing the liners, and I am attaching one acetate sheet with this to protect our photograph. Then again adding double sided tacky tape and adding one decorative frame on top of this. So this is done. Now taking back my brown base, and I'm going to connect my frame with this. So just add glue on the mount board strips and connect with the base. So it's done. Now I have prepared some beautiful vintage roses which I have shown in my last tutorial. If you haven't seen yet, I have given link in description box, you can learn from that link. So I am taking 3 medium, 2 small and 1 large rose and 2 buds and some leaves. Now here I have this beautiful vintage clock which I have made using vintage clock die and added this cute butterfly. So I'm going to attach this clock in one corner. And then I will start adhering all the flowers and leaves in both the corners. I have this beautiful element sheet cut out, so I'm adding it in this corner. On this I have added the sentiment happiness. So this is done, allow it to dry. Now I'm taking this Nuvo Crystal Clear Drops. It gives you very nice pearl effect. You just need to squeeze the bottle and drop some liquid and it will give you pearly effect. Now I'm just sliding my photograph from top. It's very easy to operate and the photo frame is ready. I'm sure you have enjoyed the video and it's looking super gorgeous. And you can easily stand it on your desk. So my project is done for today. Please subscribe my channel for more interesting videos and please click on bell icon for the latest updates and notifications. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Bye-bye.